Imagine you've driven out to the coast. It's a warm, sunny day. You're relaxing, swimming in the ocean. All your worries disappear. But then as you're sitting there, pieces of trash start floating by. And your liquid dream quickly turns into a plastic nightmare. I'm a surfer. I imagine a few of you here might be as well. And as surfers, we care deeply about the ocean and the environment. However, the equipment we ride couldn't be more toxic. This is an art installation called the 1000 Surfboard Graveyard, and its goal is to bring awareness to the carbon footprint and waste issues associated with surfboards. Now, a surfboard's biggest contributor to waste is the foam core called the blank. These foam blanks are typically made using a polymer's polyurethane or polystyrene. The issue with these foams is that they're non-renewable. They're toxic and non-biodegradable. Polystyrene foam, or as you might know it, styrofoam, takes over 500 years to degrade. And that's why right now in the US, our landfills are filled nearly one-third by a single material, polystyrene. Surely there must be a better material to make these foam blanks out of that is sustainable, that is non-toxic. Even better, what if this material is something that's currently just going to waste? Over 8 million tons of shrimp, crab, and lobster shell waste are disposed of globally every year. Of that 8 million, over 2 million of it is a biopolymer called chitin. But what is chitin? Chitin is a type of natural polymer called a polysaccharide, and it has a chemical structure very similar to that of cellulose. So if you think of cellulose as the tiny fibers that make up trees, well, chitin is the tiny fibers that make up shrimp shells. Chitin is the second most abundant polysaccharide on the planet after cellulose. It's also non-toxic, biodegradable, and sustainable. So with the enormous amount of chitin disposed of every year, it'd be amazing if we could turn this otherwise wasted material into foam and start replacing these toxic polyurethane and polystyrenes. Cruz foam does exactly that, taking chitin from shrimp shells and transforming it into a foam. Our eco-friendly, water-based process involves only water, salts, and a foaming agent. There are no toxic components. Our proof of concept seen here has comparable mechanical properties to that of existing polyurethane and polystyrene foams used in surfboards today. The application opportunities for Cruz foam are immense. With further research and development, it has the potential to go far and beyond surfboards. Thank you.